the first law of thermodynamics, the one which says that the total amount of energy is fixed, that energy can't be created or destroyed. Sometimes people, they say that that law states that there's no such thing as a free lunch, that energy is a little bit like money in a bank account, is that you can always account for it, that there is a ledger where you can add or subtract, and you can keep track of the energy. There's a beautiful example of this from Richard Feynman, where he tries to explain how energy works. And he says it's a little bit like a child who has a set of 28 wooden blocks that he uses as toys. And every day his mom comes in and she counts the blocks when she puts them back into their box. And every day she finds that there's 28. One day she finds only 26. She reasons they've got to be somewhere. And so what she starts doing is looking around. She looks behind the bed, and sure enough, a couple of blocks have ended up there. Another day, she's looking for these blocks. She only finds 15 or something. And she looks out the window, and sure enough, right, there are the remaining blocks. And in many ways, this is very much the same kind of thing. Provided you look hard enough, you'll always find that energy somewhere. So Feynman has this idea that the child says, no, you're not allowed to look in that box. And his mom says, what do you mean I'm not allowed to look? No, you can't, the child screams. What she does is she weighs the box, and she weighs the box over and over again. Every day she weighs it. And what she notices is a pattern. Sometimes it weighs a little bit more, sometimes it weighs a little bit less. But then she begins to understand what the pattern is for how many blocks are actually inside the box. So you don't necessarily actually have to see those blocks, right? You might be able to infer them in cunning ways. And in this sense, there's this idea that you don't really ever know how much there is in total, but you're constantly seeing differences, you're seeing changes. And so one of the things is that this fundamental rule is something that in science keeps us very, very safe. And whenever that rule is broken, you smell a rat. There's a snake oil salesman somewhere, right, who's trying to pull a fast one on you.